So creatine is probably the most widely researched supplement out there, at least sports enhancing supplement, with the majority of research on creatine monohydrate. But what about the other forms of creatine? Let's talk briefly about a very interesting paper on creatine HCL that crossed my computer screen recently. So we have this paper, which is a 4-week long investigation that pitted creatine monohydrate against creatine hydrochloride, also known as creatine HCL. And I will point out before we go any further that these individuals had at least 1 year of weightlifting experience under the belt. In other words, they were not beginners. The people are split up into two different groups. One group gets 5 grams of creatine monohydrate each day for a month. There is another group that gets 1.5 grams of creatine HCL. Another group gets 5 grams of creatine HCL, and then there's a control group that essentially gets resistant starch, which shouldn't have any effect on muscle strength whatsoever. And I also want to point out in the paper that they tell us at the beginning they started off with 40 individuals, but 10 of them had to be excluded because they didn't meet the criteria of the study, which in turn left them with 30 people. So what does the results say from this paper? Number one, they are telling us at the onset that there was no significant differences in strength improvement between those people who took creatine monohydrate and those people who took creatine HCL. So from this, we could assume that creatine hydrochloride would work basically as well as creatine monohydrate at producing improvements in muscle strength. Here's a table showing the before and after numbers of the individuals in this study. And there's a lot going on in this table, so let's just look at a few things. From this table, we can see that the creatine monohydrate group gained a little bit of weight, which is a common side effect from creatine monohydrate. They started out weighing around 71.1 kilograms or 156 pounds, and they ended the study weighing around 72 kilograms or 158 pounds. Now, the weight gain was not deemed to be clinically significant, but it was about 2 pounds. So again, that keeps in line with what a lot of people have said over the years, that they do gain a little bit of weight when they take creatine monohydrate. Interesting, however, there was no significant weight gain in either of the creatine HCL groups. They didn't appear to gain any weight at all. From this table, we also see that both creatine HCL groups, the 1.5 grams and the 5 grams per day group, lost about 2 pounds or 1 kilogram of fat mass. That's interesting. We also see in this table that the group who took 1.5 grams of creatine HCL lost approximately 1.5% of body fat. And they're also telling us in this table that this fat loss was deemed to be clinically significant. Okay, that's interesting, but what's curious here is that the group taking creatine hydrochloride at a dosage of 5 grams per day did not show any significant fat loss, although they do tell us that what they did lose was around 2% of their body fat. This table also tells us that those who took 5 grams a day of creatine HCL appeared to gain about 3.5 pounds or 1.6 kilograms of fat-free mass, which I take to mean muscle mass. And this increase is said to be clinically significant as well. Okay, so some very interesting findings in this paper. However, I do want to call a few things to your attention. Number one, it was a small investigation because if you look at the table, you can see that each group only had between 6 and 8 people, which is not very much per group. Another point of interest in this paper is they do tell us they started with 40 people, they weeded out 10 people, which in turn left them with 30 individuals to complete the study. However, if you add up the people in each group, it comes to 27 people. My question is, where did those 3 people go? They don't mention that in the study, so it looks like this is an even smaller investigation than we're led to believe. Another thing I noticed in the paper is that they measured body fat with skin fold calibers, which pinch people at different parts of the body. Now, skin fold analysis for body fat testing is accurate if you know what you're doing. What they don't say in the paper is that the individual or individuals who were doing the body fat testing were skilled in skin fold caliber techniques for body composition. I'm assuming that they were, but I would like to see a statement that says as much. Now, another point of interest that occurred to me is that this study was conducted in 2014. It was then published in 2015, which begs the question, where are the other creatine HCL studies that appear to show creatine HCL reduces body fat? To my knowledge, this paper has never been replicated, and what is up with that? You would think that anyone who did a study and came out with data that put a dent in the armor of creatine monohydrate would want to go on and replicate those findings, because that would send shockwaves through the dietary supplement community. So where are all those other creatine hydrochloride studies? So what do I think of this paper? Well, it's an interesting study with a curious finding. However, I'm going to say for right now, I'm skeptical of the findings that creatine HCL really does burn body fat.